Hey everyone, for today's video, we'll be taking a look at an AM5 micro ATX motherboard that sports the new entry-level AMD A620 chipset, the ASUS TUF Gaming A620M-PLUS WIFI. Sporting support for the latest Ryzen 7000 series of processors, let's have a look at this board to see if it's any good. Now the TUF Gaming A620M-PLUS WIFI that we have here today, as its name implies, sports the newly released entry-level AMD A620 chipset that gives potential consumers a cheaper opportunity to build a PC on the AM5 platform. Now, being from the TUF Gaming series of motherboard offerings targeted at gamers on a budget, where it places below the ROG Crosshair and ROG Strix series of boards, and above the value-oriented Prime series of motherboard offerings by ASUS, the A620M-PLUS WIFI can be considered a motherboard offering that sits at the higher end of the A620 spectrum. In keeping with the design language of the TUF Gaming series of products, the A620M-PLUS WIFI comes in a box sporting a silver-on-black color scheme, with touches of yellow thrown in for contrast. Moving over to the rear of the box, we get the usual summary of specs for this board. We'll take a closer look at these specs later on in this video. On a side note, if you're new to the ALKtech channel, do consider subscribing so as to keep up to date with the latest product releases in the PC hardware world. Opening up the box, we see that the board comes with a Wi-Fi antenna right here. Now, let's set aside the board for now to see what other accessories ASUS has included with it. First up, we get two SATA 3 cables, a pack of M.2 drive screws and standoffs, as well as an I/O shield. We also get a motherboard manual right here, and this is accompanied by a DVD driver disc, a quick start guide, a certificate of reliability that shows the battery off tests that some of the components on this board have been subjected to, an ASUS web storage promotional offer leaflet, as well as a sheet of TUF Gaming stickers. Onto the board itself, we see that ASUS has gone for a black and grey color scheme with touches of yellow. And as you can see, we get military-inspired motifs all around that are pretty much in line with the TUF Gaming brand identity. Being a budget-oriented motherboard, it doesn't come with an integrated I/O shield design and has black-colored heatsinks all around. Do note that this board does not come with any built-in RGB LEDs of any sort, though it does come with plenty of RGB headers for you folks out there intending to spice up your PC build with RGB bling. I'll talk about these headers later on in this video. As a more specced-out, budget-friendly motherboard offering, it's great to see that ASUS has included a relatively large heatsink to cool the board's power delivery solution. It's worth mentioning here that AMD has designed the A620 chipset to be targeted at Ryzen 7000 non-X processors with a TDP of up to 65 watts. While you might get away with using an X-class Ryzen 7000 chip with this board, you might not be able to get the most performance out of such chips due to VRM limitations, being that the A620 chipset is intended to be an entry-level offering after all. That said, the A620 has a single chipset design, and the SID chipset sits beneath this passive heatsink right here, with the TUF Gaming emblem emblazoned on it. To keep costs low, the A620M-PLUS WIFI does not come with M.2 heatsinks for the two M.2 slots that the board comes with. For memory support, the TUF Gaming A620M-PLUS WIFI comes with four DDR5 slots with support for up to 128GB of RAM and the DDR5 6400+ standard when overclocked, with plastic slots of a single-tab design that ASUS calls QDIMM. It also features AMD's Expo technology, which are basically built-in overclocking profiles for DDR5 memory, similar to what XMP stands for in Intel's ecosystem. Near the RAM slots is a USB 3.2 Gen 1 front panel header, which supports up to two USB 3.2 Gen 1 Type-A ports, as well as a USB 3.2 Gen 1 Type-C front panel header. While still on the topic of front panel USB connectivity, the bottom edge of the board houses two USB 2.0 front panel headers, with each header providing support for two USB 2.0 Type-A ports. Moving on, we also get a serial port header right here, which I suppose is useful for situations that call for the use of legacy PC peripherals. In terms of expansion slots, this board comes with a PCIe 4.0 X16 slot that sports the ASUS Safe Slot Core Plus feature that reinforces the slot against heavy graphics cards. We also do get two PCIe 3.0 X1 slots. In the storage department, ASUS has included four SATA 3 ports, with all ports in a straight-angled configuration. For M.2 slots, the board comes with two PCIe 4.0 X4 M.2 slots. Do note that these two slots support NVMe M.2 SSDs only. That said, the first slot comes with the M.2 Q-Latch feature, which facilitates the toolless installation and removal of your M.2 SSDs. For audio, ASUS has included an entry-level Realtek ALC897 audio codec. Wired internet connectivity is courtesy of a Realtek RTL8125BG chip that provides support for 2.5 gigabit Ethernet, while Wi-Fi is courtesy of MediaTek's MT7902LEN Wi-Fi 6 part, which also serves up Bluetooth 5.3 connectivity. In the cooling and RGB departments, the board comes with three fan headers that are located in these regions of the board. Also included are three addressable RGB headers and a 12-volt standard RGB header located right here. Moving over to the rear I/O, the TUF Gaming A620M-PLUS WIFI goes for a traditional I/O shield arrangement. It comes with two DisplayPort 1.4 connectors supporting display output of up to 8K resolution at 60Hz, a HDMI 2.1 port that supports display output of up to 4K resolution at 60Hz, a BIOS flashback button that allows end users to update the board's BIOS without needing to install a CPU, RAM or graphics card, two USB 3.2 Gen 1 Type-A ports, a PS2 mouse and keyboard combo port, four USB 2.0 Type-A ports, with this port here supporting the BIOS flashback feature, a 2.5 gigabit Ethernet port, Wi-Fi antenna connectors, as well as your usual audio jack connectors. With that, the ASUS TUF Gaming A620M-PLUS Wi-Fi is an interesting value-oriented AM5 motherboard offering, where despite the fact that it sports the entry-level A620 chipset, it still has a relatively good set of features for an entry-level board that, in my opinion, makes it decent enough value for money. This is especially if you're intending to build, say, an AM5 PC on a budget, with a mid-range processor offering such as the Ryzen 5 7600 or Ryzen 7 7700. For its target demographic, I appreciate the fact that we still get features such as a chunky heatsink for the VRMs, 2.5 gigabit Ethernet, and quality of life features such as M.2Q latch. One thing to note though is the fact that AMD's designed the A620 chipset for processors with a 65W TDP. While you should still be able to use a high-end Ryzen 7000 X series processor with this board, do note that the performance of such processors might be constrained by the board's VRM setup. As of mid-April 2023, the TUF Gaming A620M-PLUS Wi-Fi is available in Singapore for a price of around SGD 265 through offline and online retailers. With that, thank you so much for watching, hit the like button and get subscribed if you've enjoyed this video, and I'll catch you guys around the next time.